So this natural pacemaker of the heart, why this is natural pacemaker? Because it can generate the impulse of heartbeat. So heartbeat is beginning of heartbeat. Beat will occur from this point actually. So this is the natural pacemaker. So it can generate the impulse at the rate of 70 beats per minute. Okay. So if you see the shape of this, this is like horseshoe shape. Okay. So horseshoe shape. So shape is like horseshoe shape. Now see here, we should know the now location. Location of it. Okay, what is the location? Where is the location of
it? It is situated in the right atrium.
It is situated in the right atrium. But you should be more specific here. So while reading the features of the right atrium, you have gone through the some terminology, that is the sulcus terminalis, isn't it? So that sulcus terminalis, that is the external features of the right atrium, extend between the terminal part of the superior vena cava to the terminal part of the inferior vena cava. Okay, and this sulcus terminalis internally it is represented by the crista terminalis, isn't it? So this location of this SA node, that lies in the sulcus terminalis only, but the upper part of the sulcus terminalis where there is the termination of the superior vena cava. Okay, so the part of terminalis at the terminal part of the superior vena cava, just you can write that thing. Okay, upper part of the sulcus terminalis. Okay, so this is the location. So it will generate the heartbeat. So that is the natural pacemaker. So that is the sinoatrial node. Okay, now see here, from SA node, see, this is the SA node is here. Now from the SA node it will generate, now this impulse would be conducted throughout the heart, isn't it? So from here, see, you can see this fiber going from here. So they are the internodal bundle. Okay, so they are the internodal bundle, because one node is here. Okay, that is the atrioventricular. Okay, this is the internodal bundle. So extending between the node, see, this will fire, then this impulse is conducted throughout the atrium. Okay, through all atrial wall. Okay, now see, this is the internodal bundle. Through the internodal bundle, the impulse generated by the SA node is distributed throughout the myocardium of the atrium. Okay, so, and also see, there is the connection between the SA node and the atrioventricular node through the internodal bundle also. So see, first see, it will generate, then it will distribute to the myocardium of the atrium. So the atrium will contract first. Okay, then after some time the ventricle will contract, because see, it will take time to pass the impulse from this SA node to ventricle. Okay, just you remember this thing. For this internodal bundle, they make some delay in the contraction between the atrium and the ventricle. Okay, first atrium will contract, then after some millisecond, then ventricle will contract, because there is the gap is there. Okay, so this pathway is there. See, from here to here, it will take some time, no, to travel the impulse. So there will be delay in contraction of ventricle. Okay, there, so the atrium will contract, say after a few milliseconds, ventricle will contract. Okay, so this is internodal bundle. So these are the internodal bundle. Okay, now next is the AV bundle. Sorry, AV node first. So internodal bundle that transmit the or conduct the impulse generated from myocardium of the atrial chamber. Okay, so also to the AV node. Okay, also to the AV node also. Now see, now AV node. Now it will receive this impulse from the AV node. Okay. Now after receiving some impulse from the AV node, now AV node also fire out. Okay, it will also fire, but it fire at the rate of 60 beat per minute. Okay, that heartbeat. Okay. So this AV node, it generates the impulse at the rate of 60 beat per minute. Okay. Now we'll see the location. Where is the location of AV node? Anyone? What is the location?
Lower part of atrial septum.
Okay, lower part of atrial septum. But you forget that some terminology.
Preseptal cost.
Some terminology I taught you while reading the right atrial chamber. There was one triangle is there.
Septal cusp.
What is the name of that triangle I am asking? Triangle. So it lies just at the triangle of cusp. Okay. Triangle of cusp. Okay. Near the opening of coronary. Sinus. Okay, just remember that is just if you remember the triangle of Coats coefficient. Okay, so location that is the triangle of Coats. So it will generate the impulse at the rate of 60 beat per minute. Okay, heartbeat. Okay, so it will generate the 60 beat per minute. Just you remember. Now this impulse is see, can you see this is the atrioventricular node. Now from here the impulses will pass to the ventricle through here one bundle is there. Okay, this bundle that is the bundle of his. Okay, so the next component that is the bundle of his. Okay, see this is the bundle of his. Okay, now see, so see I have already told you that there is the no direct continuation of myocardium of atrium and ventricle. Okay, only there is the connection between the myocardium of atrium and the myocardium of ventricle through this bundle only. Okay, so that the atrium and ventricles they can contract and relax independently. Okay, they will can contract and relax independently because there is a fibrous skeleton in between there. They that make the insulation, but only there is a bundle of his that will connect the myocardium of atrium and ventricle. Okay, so this is only the electrical continuation between the myocardium of atrium and the ventricle. Just you remember this thing. So due to that only there is the delay in the conduction of nerve impulses. Okay, so that first atrium will contract and after some time the ventricle will contract. Okay, so while reading the physiology of heart you may have gone through this, isn't it? Now see here the bundle of his. Now see here from the atrioventricular bundle. So this is the conducting fiber. So it will pierce the fibrous skeleton. Okay. So there is the atrioventricular septum is there, and in there is opening is there. Through that opening, it will pass towards the ventricle. Okay. So this bundle of his now. So see, can you see here this part, this thick part here? And this thin part here, over here. So see this thick part. So this thick part, this is the muscular part of interventricular septum. And this thin part over here, this is the membranous part of interventricular septum. Because this is ventricle. So in between, from here to here, this is the interventricular septum. So interventricular septum has got a two part. One muscular part, this thick portion. So this is the muscular part, and this thin portion, this is the membranous part. So this bundle of his after piercing the atrioventricular septum, it passes along the posterior inferior aspect of the membranous part of the interventricular septum. Thus you have to know this thing also. So see, so AV bundle, so passes to to the opening atrioventricular septum. Atrioventricular septum. Okay. So there is opening. Only one opening is there. So that is the opening for bundle of his. Okay. Through that opening it will pass. Atrioventricular septum to the ventricle. Now after reaching in the ventricle, now it will pass along the posterior inferior part of membranous part of interventricular septum. Now see here, thus you can see here. So this portion, this whole thing is the bundle of his. Now see, if you see this red portion here, this thick portion, this is the muscular part, and this thin portion, this is the membranous part of interventricular septum. So three along the posterior inferior wall it will pass. Now see as it reaches the muscular part here, see now from here it will divide now. Okay, so as it reaches the upper part of the muscular part of the intermuscular septum, see this is the base is here, this is the upper part, so lower part is here. So as it reaches the upper part here, it will divide now. Okay, so on reaching the upper part of intermuscular part of interventricular septum, it will divide into two. Now see here, at the upper part only it will divide. So it is the right bundle branch and this is the left branch. So this is the right branch of bundle of his. This is the left branch of bundle of his. So now the next, that is the next component of the conducting system, that is the branch of bundle of his. Okay, that is the next component. So it has got the two branches, branch of bundle of his, and next one the left branch of bundle of his. Now see this right passes along the right side of the intermuscular part of the interventricular septum. On the left, it passes along the left side of the muscular part of the interventricular septum, isn't it? So passing towards the right and passing from the left. Now see, then after passing, see for the right, it will pass along the right side, isn't it? Now finally, this right bundle branch, as it reaches the lower part of the this interventricular septum, it passes through the one breeze like muscles in the right ventricle. What is the name of that breeze like trabeculae carnae in right ventricle? What is the name of that muscle? What is the name of that breeze like breeze?
Papillary muscle.
No, that is the pillar like. So there is the one breeze like muscles you will see in case of right ventricle only. We have heard about it. Have you heard about this terminology initially?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So septum marginal trabeculae are moderated band. So after reaching the lower part of the septum, it passes through one breeze-like muscular muscles. That muscles, that is the septum marginal trabeculae, that extend between the lower part of the interventricular septum to the base of anterior papillary muscles in right ventricle, isn't it? So finally it passes from this, but see, then after it will divide and distribute in all right ventricular cavity. Okay, similarly left will passes along the left margin of the interventricular septum, then it will distribute to the left ventricle. Okay. Okay. So the final component of the conducting system, that is the Purkinje fiber. So this Purkinje fiber, see, you can see here. Can you see this bluish color here? So they see. So as it passes, see. So this impulse, it should be distributed to each myocardium. Okay, each cells of the myocardium. So see, this bundle, they will divide into finer and finer and finer, and then finally this impulse is passed to each cells of the myocardium through the Purkinje fiber only. So this Purkinje fiber, they forms the network. Okay, finer network. Okay. So finally, the so final component, that is the so Purkinje fiber, they forms the network of conducting system. Okay, the finer network. Finer network. Okay, this network just lie beneath the endocardium. So it forms the subendocardial network. Okay, so endocardium, there is the covering is three layers in the heart. Okay, epicardium, myocardium, endocardium, isn't it? Just below the endocardium, it forms the network. Okay, so subendocardial network is formed by the Purkinje fiber, and the impulses of heartbeat is distributed to each cell of the myocardium. Okay. Subendocardial. Then the impulse of heartbeat is distributed. Impulse of beat is distributed to each cells of the myocardium. Okay, are you getting up to here? So this is about the conducting system. Then what will happen if any defect is there in the conducting system? What will happen if any defect is there in this conducting system? There will be the arrhythmia. So there is change in the heartbeat pattern, isn't it? Are you listening?
Yes,
so if any defect in the conducting system, lead to the arrhythmia. Okay, so there is the change in the rhythm of the heartbeat. So there is the, normally there is the particular rhythm is there, isn't it? So that rhythm will change. Okay, so alteration will occur there. Okay, arrhythmia, dysrhythmia. Okay, so just you remember these things. So they are the component of conducting system. Yes, I know that is the natural pacemaker that will generate the impulse of heartbeat. Okay. So from here, there is the distribution of the heartbeat. Okay, impulses to the all the myocardium of the atrium. Then see, these impulses will pass to the atrioventricular node also. Then atrioventricular node, on feeling that sensation, again it will fire at the rate of 60 beats per minute. So this impulses is traveled through the bundle of His to the ventricle. Okay, this bundle of His divided into the right and the left branch. So this right branch, okay, this passes along the right side of the septum into ventricular septum and finally to the moderator vein, the whole left ventricle. Okay, so then finally that is the Purkinje fiber. They are the finer network formed beneath the endocardium, that forms the subendocardial plexus, and the impulse of heartbeat is distributed to each cells of the ventricular myocardium actually. Okay, myocardium. Then after that the ventricle will contract. Okay, so atrium will contract and after some time ventricle will contract. Okay, so there is the time delay is there in between the atrial contraction and the ventricular contraction. Thus you remember this thing. Okay. Now next. What may be the next heading for heart? So this is about the conducting system. Okay. Now minor headings are there. Okay. Now the atrial supply to the heart.
Sir, we have another class.
Okay. How fast? Okay then. We'll continue next class then.